Today, I'm going to do one of the most fun experiments that I have been doing for a long, long time. And of course, I'm going to do that from the Delphi IDE with a Delphi application. And as my background here suggests, the topic of this experiment will be artificial intelligence. What are we going to do? We have created a component for the FNC Cloud Pack that can seamlessly communicate with different large language models. And it includes the one from OpenAI, Anthropic Claude model, Perplexity, also Grok from X, Google Gemini, and also the Olama large language model that you can actually run for free yourself on your own computer. And so what are we going to do? We are going to set up a conversation between these different large language models about the topic, you can guess it, about Delphi. I have no idea where this conversation will lead to, where it will end, what direction it will take, but we will do a question and answer between the different large language models, and let's just see what happens. And this is Delphi 12.2, from where we will run that experiment. We created a FireMonkey application, and in that FireMonkey application, we have a memo control that will contain the prompt that we send to the large language model. We have a memo that will capture the response received from the large language model, and we have two extra parameters that we can set. The parameter that sends the system role to the large language model, and one that sends the assistant role. So these are two additional guiding parameters for the large language model to guide how it should treat the prompt, how it should respond to that prompt. And we have at the bottom here a combo box from where we send the select the large language model that we want to use, and a button to perform an explain, and a button to perform a questioning. Let's have a look in detail. So when we click the explain button, we set up the roles in such way that it should behave as an IT expert and write a short paragraph about what is in the prompt. When on the other side we click on the question button, we want that large language model will, based on the content that we sent, generate itself, come up itself with exactly one intelligent question about that content. And as you can see here, this is the prompt that we sent. You can see here that the prompt that we sent is always based on the previous response. So either it will be the question that we ask the large language model to come up with, or it will be the content itself that was generated based on the previous answer. When we have set up these roles, we use the FNC AI component to actually perform the request to the large language model. And here it is very simple that we select the service to send the prompt to, set up the prompt itself, set up both roles, and then eventually execute. Then we have the onExecuted event handler, and this event handler is executed when the large language model responded. And what we do is capture the response and set it in the memo, and show also along with that some statistical information. And here in the constructor of the form, we have created an instance of that FNC Cloud AI component, and we have set up the API keys for the different large language models that we will use in this experiment. So it's more than time now to start our fun experiment and launch this application and see what is going to happen in the battle of the large language models. And we will launch the first question to OpenAI. What do you know about Delphi? And let's see what OpenAI comes up with. It gives us the expected one short paragraph answer about what is Delphi or what it knows about Delphi. Now I will ask Grok, the X large language model service, I will ask Grok to ask or to come up with one intelligent question about this paragraph. And it asks, what are some key features of the Delphi FireMonkey framework that distinguishes it from the visual component library that we all know for Windows development? So totally unexpected, it is taking us in the direction in this conversation to compare FireMonkey versus VCL. And we'll ask Gemini, Google's Gemini, to explain us a little bit about the differences between FireMonkey and the VCL framework. Again, it was totally unpredictable, this way of this conversation, but let's see where it takes us. And here we see that Google Gemini indeed answers that the difference is in cross-platform support. Graphics and rendering techniques are also different. UI controls and styling. It tells a little bit about layout management, code sharing, mobile development, etc. We are not going over all the details, but this is what Gemini came up with. And again, time for an intelligent question. We will ask Claude to come up with such an intelligent question. No idea where this will take us. And here it asks us, it goes into quite technical, in a quite technical direction here in this conversation, how the GPU accelerated vector based rendering engine, how that compares between, for example, DirectX on Windows and OpenGL on macOS. So, challenging technical question. We'll ask that question to the Perplexity, a large language model. So, Perplexity, please explain us something about that. And again, we get an elaborated answer for the difference between DirectX, OpenGL, and things like that. Again, we're not going to go in detail about that. And we will ask the large language model, the next one, Olama in this case, to come up with an intelligent question. And actually, we will want to start the task manager. And you will see here that the Olama service is running on my machine locally here. And to prove that, let's bring it up so that you can see it. When I click the question button, you can see here that Olama kicks in action. And here is the question from Olama. How does the use of 3D graphics APIs impact the performance and the power consumption of mobile devices when these engines are used? And like this, we can go on forever. We can pick another service. Let's see what, for example, Olama explains based on its own question. That's also a different angle that we can take this experiment. And here you can see Olama answering its own question. And we can go on and on. We can continue questions and keep the conversation alive. And maybe in the process, learn ourselves also different things about that. That was the fun experiment that I wanted to share with you here in this video. We will make this source code available so that you can play yourself. So I wish you a lot of fun. And if While playing with it, you come up with different conversations on different topics that are really fun and interesting to share. Let us know. We are, of course, eager to learn how what you do with it and what kind of experiments and fun you have with these large language models. Thanks for watching. If you want to continue to see fun content like this, don't forget to subscribe here on this YouTube channel. Till next time.